See, male is different. Female organs are born on a different individual. So what are the events in sexual reproduction? These are the events of sexual reproduction. First, male gamete and female gamete will fuse, form a zygote. Zygote will undergo embryogenesis, which is embryo formation. And so, and that embryo, it will further grow and mature, and it will form a fully functional individual. So this event, this whole event is divided into three parts. To make it easier, pre-fertilization, fertilization, and post-fertilization. Pre-fertilization events are which occur before fertilization. Fertilization as in when male gamete and female gamete fuse. So first is, in order to make the two gametes fuse, first of all, you should have gametes. So we will learn how gametes are formed. Then we should know how gametes are met. How do they meet? So that is your gamete transfer. Let's see how gametes are formed. What are gametes? Gametes are germ cells. You must know there are somatic cells and germ cells. So it's a germ cell. It combines with another germ cell and it produces a zygote, and zygote grows into an organism. I should have put a comma here, is called a gamete. Organism is not called a gamete. Organism is called an organism only. So gametes are of two types, male and female. Male and female gametes, you generally, more often than not, they can be differentiated on basis of size, shape, and structure. And but there are some exceptions. We'll see how. So on basis of appearance, gametes are of two type, homogametes, which are similar in size, shape, and shape and structure. So you can't differentiate which one is which is male and which is female in here. Like for example, an algae called Cladophora, its gametes, these are two gametes. You don't know which is male, which is female. They are same. They look the same. They appear to be same. So they are called homogametes or isogametes. Now there are heterogametes. Majority of sexually reproducing individuals, they form heterogametes, different types of gametes. One will be male and one will be female. Male gamete is generally called sperm or entherozoid. Entherozoid in case of plants. Female gamete is generally called ovum or egg. So this is your, these are your heterogametes. This is of, these are your heterogametes. These are your human gametes. This is egg. These are the sperms. Same is the case here. So gamete formation. So you know human beings are diploid individuals. So how do we stay diploid? So in order for a individual, for a human being to stay diploid, which is 2N, gametes have to be N. So how do they become N? So let's talk about haploid organisms. Organisms which are haploid throughout the, we human beings are 2N, and there are some individuals which are N. So what happens in those? So this is your individual haploid. It will undergo mitosis and it will form a haploid gamete. Those two gametes will fuse, gametes. These gametes are formed by mitosis. There is no reduction. So the chromosome number remains the same as in the parent. And these two gametes will form a diploid 2N individual, which will undergo meiosis. Why will it undergo meiosis? It will undergo meiosis because the organism has to be the adult organism, the mature individual, it has to be haploid. So it will, 2N will undergo meiosis and it will form a haploid organism. In diploid organism, what happens is, for example, this is your human 2N. It undergoes meiosis. The human doesn't undergo meiosis. It's not going to happen like you are sitting like a man or a woman is sitting and they, you know, there are four of them, it's not going to, you know, it's not going to be the case. So a 2N individual, it undergoes meiosis. The germ cells, in the germ cell, in reproductive organs, there is meiosis in certain cells. They will form haploid gametes. Like, for an example, in humans, in testes and ovaries, there are certain cells called meiocytes. So there are certain cells which undergo meiosis to form haploid gamete. The whole individual doesn't have to undergo meiosis. So the reproductive structure, some cells will undergo meiosis, will form haploid gametes. Haploid gametes will fuse and form 2N offspring, diploid offspring. So these are the number of your meiocytes, diploid and haploid. And so, see, for example, if human beings have 46 chromosomes, so gametes will have 23. Housefly has 12, gametes will have half of it, 6. So these are all your diploid individuals. These are all diploid individuals, and these are the gametes. So these are this is the 2N number. So we can guess, we can, you know, fill this table. Like, if gametes are 16 in onion, then 32 is going to be the chromosome number. So like that, you can solve it.